In today's video, I'm going to be giving you guys my expectations for the Vancouver Canucks heading into next season. Last year was a pretty bad season for the Vancouver Canucks, but no one really expected anything more. But heading into next year, they're entering a new era now that the Sedin twins have officially retired, and now the youth are going to take a lead in the organization. And I think that's pretty exciting for Canucks fans, as there's a lot of young talent in the organization. They finished last year with a record of 31-40-11 for 73 points, which was good for 7th in the Pacific Division, only ahead of the Arizona Coyotes. Their leading point scorer was Besser and Sedin, both tied for 55 points. That is Daniel Sedin. And their leading goal scorer was Brock Besser with 29 goals. And if he stayed healthy and played in all 82 games, I could have seen that goal total be up to around 39-40, because he did miss a good chunk of the season. And he probably would have been a finalist for the Calder. Well, he already was a finalist for the Calder Trophy, but he probably would have made it a closer race between him and Matthew Barzell. But all in all, they didn't really expect much from the Canucks last season. It was a bad year, yes, but what did you expect? They didn't have a roster that was able to make the playoffs. The goaltending wasn't good enough. They didn't have enough forward depth. And right now, they're really in the midst of a rebuild. Next year is kind of the first year, as now the Sedin twins are gone. I think it's going to be good for them to get another top draft pick next year in a draft where you could get a guy like Kaapo Kakko or Jack Hughes. So a lot of good talent in next year's draft, and I definitely think that is something to look forward to for the Vancouver Canucks. And still, it'll be fun to watch them next year, as it's going to be very interesting to see how their young players develop, because they definitely don't have any shortage of young talent. It was a pretty quiet offseason for the Vancouver Canucks. They signed Jay Beagle and Antoine Roussel because Benning said he wanted to bring in more sandpaper and grit to the lineup. And a lot of people are hating for what they gave money to these guys, but they have a lot of cap space. And in the coming years, they're not really going to have to use any of that cap space in the next 2 or 3 years. So I actually am a fan of these moves, because the Vancouver Canucks didn't really have any of this grit in their bottom six last season. And I really do like it, because you need these players on every team, in my opinion, and I think Jay Beagle is the perfect fourth line guy, and I think Roussel can play a really good third or fourth line role as well. And a lot of people are hating on the money that they gave these guys, but they don't need that money right now. So obviously, bringing in veterans, this is pretty much saying, come show these guys how to play in the NHL, show these young players the way, and then pretty much leave is what is going to happen with Roussel and Beagle. But I actually like this signing. It's going to make your bottom six tougher to play against. So the people that are hating on this, I think you have to look at it in the perspective as you need these players. You don't really need the cap space right now. You still have plenty even after signing these guys. So I actually do like these signings. A lot of people might feel differently, but you do need these players on a lineup, and it's going to be good for them to teach the young guys how to play in the NHL, because you can't just have a lineup all filled with young players, as that isn't going to work out very well. So all in all, I think the Vancouver Canucks played it safe and had a decent offseason. Now getting into my lineup predictions, I used Roster Resource to kind of look at their depth charts, and this is by no means what it is going to look like. This is kind of just my speculation. I don't watch the Vancouver Canucks too much. Whenever I do get the chance, I do, but their games are usually on way later here over on the East Coast. But I think the first line is pretty much solidified with Barchi, Horvat, and Brock Besser, and I think that would be a really good second line right now, because I'm not really sure if Barchi is a first line NHL player. Can he make a good jump next season? But Bo Horvat and Brock Besser in the next coming years are definitely going to be first line forward. So Horvat and Besser I do like, but Barchi, I definitely think he can chip in and produce some good offensive numbers, but I'm not quite sure if he's an NHL first liner. I think he'd be more suited for a second line role, but obviously on a rebuilding team, you're not going to have an amazing first line. Second line, I think we're going to see Louis Erickson, Elias Pettersson, and Jake Virtanen. And Virtanen is kind of the wild card on this line, because he really does have to make a jump sooner or later, as a lot of people think he's a huge bust, but I think he still has the potential to be a 25-50 point scorer. So it's going to be interesting to see what he does next season. I think playing him with a skilled guy like Pettersson and a veteran like Erickson, I think that line can produce some pretty decent offensive numbers. Yes, they're not the biggest line, they're kind of soft, but obviously a rebuilding team with young guys like that, you're not going to have that physicality. That is what the signings of Beagle and Roussel are for. And then the third line, I have Gagner, Suter, and Gaudette. I think Gagner is a pretty decent third liner. I don't like the contract that he's on, but I definitely think he's still capable of 15 goals and 40 points. So it's going to be interesting to see what he does if he can stay healthy. I like Brandon Sutter as a third line center. He was always one of my favorite guys in the NHL. when he played for Pittsburgh, and I think he's a really good third line center. So I think that's a pretty decent third line. And then you have Adam Gaudette there, who's obviously a physical guy coming over from college. I definitely think he's going to make the lineup, and I don't know really what his ceiling is, if he's going to be a top six forward. I'm thinking more of a top nine guy who really is a physical scoring third line forward. So I like Adam Gaudette, but I'm not sure if he's going to be a star in the NHL by any means. So a decent third line. And then the fourth line, you have Leipzig, Beagle, and Roussel, obviously two offseason signings, and that is kind of the shutdown line. So obviously you can mess around with these lines and then scratch to have Granlund and Schaller. I've never really been a fan of Marcus Granlund. He did play a pretty good chunk of games for the Canucks last season, but I definitely think a guy like Gaudette and obviously the new signings of Roussel and Beagle will have him out of the lineup. And Schaller is a guy obviously you can also bring in if someone is to get injured. And you obviously have guys like Jonathan Dahlin you could bring in. You have guys like Goldobin. It's going to be interesting to see where they put in all those young guys, because I definitely think they might get a shot to make it if they have a good preseason. But this is kind of what I see the roster looking and shaping up like on opening night. Now taking a look at the Vancouver Canucks defense core heading into next season, and this is where I think it's wide open what the lineups could be. Obviously, I'm putting in just the veterans first, and that's what I think it could look like on opening night, depending on how the preseason goes and how training camp goes. I have Edler and Tanev on the top pairing, Delzato and Hutton, and then Pouliot and Gabranson. In goal, you have Markstrom and Nielsen, but as you can see on the sides, you have Hughes and Ylevi. And in my opinion, they're going to get all the chance in the world to make this team. Hughes is an unbelievable skater, and I definitely think he's going to get a crack at the lineup, and he could take out a guy like Pouliot. And then you have a guy like Ylevi, who Ben Hutton I don't really think is solidified in this lineup. And I definitely think a guy like Ylevi, if he comes in, has a really good training camp and a pretty good preseason, them two easily could make this lineup. And I think that would be a huge benefit for the Vancouver Canucks, and it really would make their D core a little bit better than it is, because obviously that's a pretty weak defense core. Edler is getting up there in age. They're only real top four defenseman in my opinion in that top four that should be there is Chris Tanev. So if a guy like Hughes and Ylevi can come in, I think that would be a huge boost, and I definitely think Vancouver Canucks fans would like that, because it just gives you that much more young talent to watch and kind of monitor over the season. And then in goal, it's pretty bad as well. Markstrom and Nielsen, that could be one of the worst goaltending tandems in the NHL. But over there, you can see they have Thatcher Demko. So obviously, the future is bright. It doesn't look very good right now, but in a couple years, I think Thatcher Demko is going to be able to come in and take that number one spot, and they have DiPietro as well. So it's going to be interesting to see how long it takes Hughes and Ylevi to really become full-time NHLers. But I could see through midway through the season, them both being mainstays in that lineup. I don't know if Thatcher Demko will get too many chances in the lineup, but it'll be interesting to see. But obviously the future is bright, it just doesn't really look good right now. Now taking a look at my player stats predictions, and remember to take this with a grain of salt, I don't see all these guys playing in all 82 games. This is kind of just my points per 82 games, if you will. So I have Brock Besser leading the team. I definitely think that's going to happen next year if he does stay healthy. 82 games played, 39 goals and 32 assists for 71 points. I definitely think he's capable of that. I think he could break the 40 goal mark next year. You could argue he would have this year if he was to stay healthy. I really do hope that injury isn't a recurring problem, but I don't think it will be. And if he does stay healthy, I could definitely see him putting up a good amount of points and being one of the best goal scorers in the NHL as soon as next season. Then you have Bo Horvat, 21 goals and 46 assists for 67 points, which would I think would be a pretty good season. I think he'll be the next captain of the Canucks, and those assists come from feeding Brock Besser the majority of the time, so I definitely think he'll have a good amount of assists. Then I have Pettersson, 24 goals and 39 assists for 63 points. I think if he makes the team and plays in every game, he definitely will have 60 plus points. He's too talented not to. He'll be playing on the top power play unit in my opinion, or at least I would have him up there. And then you have Barchi playing on that first line, 19 goals and 43 assists. Like Horvat, getting a lot of assists because he'll be feeding Besser the majority of the time, 62 points. Louis Eriksson, 18 goals, 35 assists for 53 points, in which would be a pretty good sign for the Vancouver Canucks. But I definitely don't see Louis Eriksson playing in all 82 games, but this is kind of just if he does, what I think he's still capable of, because I definitely think he is still capable of 45 to 50 points. Then Jake Virtanen, 20 goals and 29 assists for 49 points, in which I think would be a really good year. If he plays on a line with Pettersson the whole season, I definitely think he's capable of 20 goals and almost 50 points. So this is kind of just what I see it looking like. You could have guys like Sam Gagne maybe in here, but I don't really see too much offensive firepower on this team besides the top two lines. So that's kind of what I based it off of. Let me know down in the comments section who you think will be the leading scorer and just kind of some stat predictions. I definitely hope for Vancouver Canucks' sake that Jake Virtanen does take a big step forward next season, because it's going to be interesting to see how much longer of a shot he has of making this team. But next year, he's going to get all the opportunity in the world to be a mainstay and a really important part of the team, just because they're in full rebuild mode. And now there's just going to be a lot of opportunity in Vancouver. Now, heading into my final expectations for the Canucks next season, I think they're going to be worse than they were last year, but that's not necessarily a bad thing as long as your young players continue to progress and continue to get better. You take away the franchise players, Sedins, from this team, and obviously I think they're going to get worse, but you bring guys like Pettersson, it's going to be interesting to see what happens, but I definitely think a last place finish in the league and a top two pick in next year's draft would do wonders for this team. You add one more fantastic prospect like a Hughes, like a Kaku to this team, and I definitely think then it's time to start bringing in some solid veterans, and then you could have a playoff contending team in the next couple of years. So I do like the look of this team heading forward into the future, not necessarily right now, but obviously in the future I think this team is going to be a force to be reckoned with out west. Leading goal scorer, you guys seen that in the player stats predictions. I have Besser with 39 and Besser with 71 points. So that is kind of my overall expectations for the Canucks. Canucks fans, don't get triggered at the record and finishing last in the Pacific Division. I don't think that's a bad thing because your future is so bright, and obviously I think another top draft pick would just do wonders for this team and really solidify that young prospect core that they have. So that really is going to wrap it up. Those are my final expectations for the Canucks heading into next season. So that is going to wrap up the video. I really hope you guys did enjoy. Make sure to let me know down in the comments section your expectations for the Vancouver Canucks heading into next season, especially from Canucks fans. I want to hear what you guys think. And with that being said, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please make sure to drop a like on it and subscribe to the channel for daily NHL content. And I'll see you guys all in the next video.